subscribe to James the Sheriff Dixon, you motherfuckers.
The subject known as TikTok has the stolen OSS mini disc. Alpha and Bravo teams move in to apprehend the target. He's got time bombs.
Be careful what you wish for.
TikTok has the stolen OSS mini disc and is on the move.
Sorry, I can't hang around.
I'm coming with a 13. On-site arrival in 4 minutes.
We don't have 4 minutes. I'll get him faster with the zip line. If I don't catch him now, who knows how many people he'll free?
You forgot one tiny detail. You're pregnant.
What's going on, guys? James here bringing another video. For this one, I'll be doing my weekly Bad Movie Friday vid. And this Friday, I'll be talking about movie Spy Kids 4, All the Time in the World. This will be capping off the Spy Kids movies. It's not a trilogy because there's four of them. So this will be the last Spy Kids movie that we're going to be watching. Or I should say, I'll be reviewing. This is also the last trilogy of movies that I'll be doing for the year. So also that. And also, this is my 190th Bad Movie review. So we are 10 officially away from 200 Bad Movie reviews. Let's go, guys. I just want to say thank y'all for watching and continuing support. And we'll get to 200 next year, y'all. Let's do it. So, on IMDb, let's see the IMDb here. So, on IMDb, has a 3 out of 10 stars. And I'm giving this a 2 out of 5. Came out in 2011, and it's an hour and 29 minutes long. I personally thought it should have been an hour and 20 minutes, but that's just me. I did not see this in theaters when it came out. As a kid, I was in high school back in 2011, and I remember the friends that saw it, they did not like it, so I didn't bother. It wasn't until like a few years later when it was like airing on TV, and not only then did I see it, and I didn't see it fully. This is my first time seeing it fully for doing a review for this channel. So, yeah, and also when it came out, I remember this is the first time I've ever heard about 4D, because some of the theaters around me were selling like these scratch-off tickets, or that you could scratch and sniff and at certain times in the movie and feel like you're there. So, So, yeah. So, for the budget of this movie is... Budget. All the way down. $27 million, and they got back worldwide $85 million. They also have the U.S. and Canada opening, which is only $11 million. So, they lost money on the U.S. and Canada, but they gained it back with the worldwide. Okay, so... story. So for the story of this, there's this villain called the Timekeeper, and he's trying to go back in time and save his dad from dying. His other story is he was trapped and literally trapped in time. Because the OSS was working on a way to control time, and his dad was in charge of that. So the kid was frozen in time, and then he got out of that, got unstuck from that, and then he watched his dad die in front of him. So his story is to go back and save his dad, and he never could do it. So there's multiple versions of them in this movie that you don't realize until, like, towards the end of the movie. And, and one of the versions of him is called the Timekeeper, like I just said. And his voice is, like, high through the movie, so it's kind of constantly high and annoying. And the new spies in this movie are a family that's divorced. Not divorced, the mom died. And the dad marries another lady, and she has to take care of the kids. And the kids don't really like the mom, so there's pranks pulled on her throughout this movie. And this is like a totally different feel from the first three movies. This one also has Ricky Rabbit starring as a talking dog. And he tries to land jokes that they just don't land because it's like, come on, Ricky. This is a kids movie. What are you doing? And Carmen and Judy are in this. I thought they were in this way more than I thought they were going to be. They show up at about a half hour, 40-minute mark to help the kids. And it is their original actors as adults now in the storyline as well. And they're related to this family because the mom is also their aunt. I should have added that there. But yeah, they show up about halfway through the movie, and then they're there for the rest of the movie to help the family save the day. And they do. And Joel McHale's in it as the dad. And yeah, I don't really have much more to say other than they do have a baby in this. And they call the baby Spy Baby because the baby can do karate and shit, which is... The CGI was just terrible in this movie compared to the other ones. I know the third one, like, the CGI was meant to be bad because it was a 3D aspect, but this one, you can just tell, was terrible. They didn't really care when they made this one. Antonio Banderas does not make an appearance as the dad, which I thought he was the best, pretty much, actor in the other movies. And there's only one reference of a machete in this movie, because he's seen in when they're, the time freezes, he is seen in the lab making his gadgets for OSS. So that's the story. Like I said, 2 out of 5 stars. And yeah, I really don't have much more to say other than I will show you guys the scenes I thought best represented this movie. And I'll be back again in a second, everybody. See y'all then.
Armageddon, also known as the Wells Experiment. Back in the day, this contraption almost caused the end of the world as we know it. That's why the OSS shut the experiment down and placed the device in level 13 lockdown where it remains today. The fate of the world is on the line here. That's why I'm calling upon one of our most valued and skilled operatives, Agent Cortez. He has even come out of retirement to help us.
It's good to be back.
And you never should have left. Where have you been the last 7 years?
If I told you, then it wouldn't be called a secret mission.
It's not like I missed you or anything. I needed a break from your face.
Oh, what an incredible coincidence. I needed a break from yours.
Oh, whatever. What's going on over there?
Shh. Family reunion.
This isn't about us, Carmen. This is about saving the world.
You don't deserve to wear this badge.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Spy hunter here. As you can see, I'm in some sort of underground secret lair where the battle for freedom and justice is being fought by our country's top spies. I really can't see much from up here, but we can zoom in with our spy hunt cam and get a closer look.
Oh, the kids are gonna flip when they see this.
Did you get that? You gotta go! Go! Go!
Argonaut, do something!
What do you want me to do? I'm a lover, not a fighter.
Attack them!
Attack mode activated. It's showtime!
Go, Argo, go!
Oh, someone put that on YouTube!
Time flies when you're having fun.
Backyard. Let me go. It's all part of the plan.
So those were the scenes I thought best represented this movie. Like I said, a lot of annoying time puns in this movie. So I guess without rambling, I will show you guys what I have in store for next week's Bad Movie Friday. Be right back again in a second, everybody.
Bolted to the wall.
We'll be doing a movie called Zoom starring Tim Allen, which is his superhero movie from the early 2000s. So yeah, I guess with that, I'll be bringing this video to a close. Before I close it, though, I just want to say again, thank you all for continuing to watch and support this channel. And, 200 bad movie reviews next year. Cheers, mate. This is James saying, if you like what we've been seeing, please like and subscribe more. This is James saying, peace. I'll let Brandon Rogers take away from here. See y'all on the next one, everybody.
Right, I just want to shout out an amazing channel, James the Sheriff Dixon. Oh, he's such a great guy, and he is super cool for coming to the show. I'm glad I got to meet him in person, and you should subscribe.